You've never tried Ibuki in this game? She's got some good tools. She's a pretty alright character. Ibuki was also pretty different. She has unlimited kunai. Wouldn't you love that fate? Oh, nice. Oh, and she has like, she also has a sort of dive kick thing. Oh, and, yeah, they changed Ibuki a ton too. I forgot about that. Dang, I tried to get electric. Unlimited kunai was good, like, yeah. So I can do something like that. Why do you keep donating so much? Stop it.
I'm just
coming here to start stuff.
On your conscious that you banned and continuously lie about someone who helped you more than your own life.
Hello everybody, today I want to talk about why I enjoy playing Street Fighter Cross Tekken Ibuki, and no, this has nothing to do with the fact that Smash came out yesterday and I can't play it because it's being used at work right now, and today's my day off. Anyways, there's five things I want to go over. Mobility, flexibility, her weaknesses are not that bad, she's really underrated, and this is kind of, the last one's kind of subjective, but when I play her, I don't really feel at a disadvantage against top tiers. Now, when I play Street Fighter Cross Tekken Ibuki, I feel like I could be pretty much anywhere in the screen. For example, here's a comparison of how she would catch up to someone that was hit with a right on Cross Tekken, compared to how she would catch up with someone who did she did Hard Punch right up to in Street Fighter V. Whenever I play her in Street Fighter V, I feel like kind of she's in cement shoes or something, you know, there's something up with her. I just don't see why, but she seems really slow to me. But in Street Fighter Cross Tekken, it feels very good in terms of how mobile she is. And kind of to compare, to show my point, I want to take the idea of a user called Nero on YouTube who did a video about Majora's Mask 3D. I want to show you a comparison on how fast Ibuki could get from one part of the stage to the other in Street Fighter 4 and in Cross Tekken. So, first one to go reach forward and back wins. As you could see, Street Fighter Cross Tekken Ibuki was able to make it before and after, but not only that, there were some interlapping frames in that she wouldn't move because her forward and back dash are so far. Second thing I would like to talk about is flexibility. What I mean by flexibility is that she tends to always have an answer, or if not an answer, then a mitigation tool. One of the things is anytime I see a new situation, I could usually go into training mode and find a solution because of the many properties she has. While she doesn't have a wake up reversal, she does have things like low profiles. She does have things like a command dash that could switch sides. And she like has mobility. All these things, I could always find something to mitigate. If there's a M. Bison player that I always wake up with EX Psycho Crusher, I could just switch sides instead of safe jumping. If a Tekken character realizes you are backdashing their false block strings and starts delaying their stuff, you could just ride at them. If there's a character with long pokes, let's just call him Lars, has long pokes and a Discord owner is claiming he beats Ibuki easily, I could just use anti-Lars tech. I gotta make a video on that. All these things just mean that whenever I play Ibuki, I always seem to have an answer for pretty much everything any character throws at me. One of the things many people tend to point to is her weaknesses. And yes, they are glaring, but at the same time, they are really not that bad. Yes, she doesn't have wake-up reversals, but you know what? It actually promotes good blocking. Notice whenever I play how many times I could just block sequences. This compounded with a backdash that was the furthest reaching backdash in Street Fighter 4, and Ryda, you could actually mitigate this shortcoming very easily. A lot of other people will point to the fact that she has only 900 HP, but that is not really a problem. Many characters don't have much health, and I think Nina's around the same tier, and people find huge success with her. It's just you can't play her the exact same way you play many other characters. But that is not a bad thing. She has answers for many things. You got a zoning Akuma, you got an answer for it. You got a Lars poking with a fraud crouching medium kick, you have answers for it. I do feel she is very underrated too. Like I mentioned before, many people point to her faults and like she can't be good. But that is not really true. She has so many things going for her that these same people do not realize. She has things like a 3-frame jab. Many top tiers do not have them. I think the only two are Chun-Li and Nina. She has a special 2-frame normal that no other character has. That doesn't include supers. And you know, when you include supers, the top tiers do not have so anything like that. She also has one of the best finishers in the game. And yes, she has conflicting motions with her normals, but that also leads to option selects that even Tekken characters could not have because of the way Tekken chains work. Yes, they're called Tekken chains, not target combos, Blue. And lastly, I never feel at a disadvantage when I'm against top tiers. Horang, Law, well, especially Law, Nina, Chun-Li, I could always battle them on even footing. I think that her only real bad matchups are somewhere in the middle. Characters like Marduk give her problems because of the way they're designed. But aside from that, the top tiers, I feel she could go toe-to-toe with some tactics, like I've pointed out before in videos. She could punish that. Characters that are higher tier than her cannot deal with. I seriously think that she is top 10, or even close to top 5, if not top 5 already. Either way, let me know what you think of these kind of videos. I know it's kind of cliche for people to kind of end like this, but it's something I tried, just mostly because my PS4 is updating right now. So, thank you for watching. I hope you continue watching Cross Tekken because I really do enjoy that game, even if Smash Ultimate just came out and my PS4 messed up for some reason. But yeah, I will see all of you later. Goodbye.